We're talking about wheel bearings today. So what is a wheel bearing? Every car has a wheel bearing, every vehicle has a wheel bearing, actually it has four of them, one on each wheel. And the purpose of the wheel bearing is to allow the wheels to rotate freely with the minimal amount of friction. Wheel bearings come in several types, and I've got three samples to show today. So the first one, this is the tapered roller bearing. This is a bearing, it's been around for a long time. You'll find it on the front ends of a lot of American cars from the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. On your typical rear wheel drive type of vehicle. These are a serviceable bearing. You can pack them with grease. And they should be serviced every once in a while. And also they're adjustable as well. Our second type of bearing, this is the one piece sealed wheel bearing. This bearing, basically there's two bearings inside and there's a seal on each side. So it's waterproof. And this bearing is pressed into a hub, so you need special tools. Nothing serviceable. When this bearing wears out, you just replace it. The third type is a unitized hub assembly. This contains the bearing, located here, the bearing mount, which is this piece here, the hub, and the ABS brake sensor. So this piece bolts in and bolts out. And generally, it's a slip-in, slip-out type of thing, but what happens is when a car gets 5 or 10 years old, it usually gets rusty and requires a lot of persuasion to remove it. But this is the most expensive part, as you can well imagine, because of the components, but it can often be easier to replace if it doesn't seize in place. And they use these on everything from a small car right up to a Ford F-350 Super Duty pickup truck, which has 8 studs. It's an enormous piece and expensive. So as a car owner, you might wonder, well, what kind of wheel bearing do I have? How do I tell? And really, the only way to know is to look in a service manual, call the parts department at your dealer or a parts shop, see what kind of wheel bearings they take, or call your mechanic and find out, and he can let you know, or she. The wheel bearing is located right in behind here. This is the disc brake rotor. If we remove this, we'll find the wheel hub. That's what the rotor is bolted onto. And in behind there is the wheel bearing. Like most parts in your vehicle, wheel bearings will wear out. And they'll wear out usually one of two ways. One is they'll make a noise, and you'll notice this when you're driving a car down the road. The noise will get louder and louder as the faster you go. Or the bearing will have excessive play. Now the play will be noted when you have when the vehicle's inspected on a hoist. And with the wheel on, you can wiggle the wheel and road wheel back and forth. And if there's any movement, that means the bearing's worn out. Now some tapered roller bearings can be adjusted, but normally other types of bearings, the unitized and the pressed-in wheel bearing, if there's any play, that they need to be replaced. Once a problem is found with the wheel bearing, you should replace it as soon as possible. While wheel bearings can be noisy for a long time, they can run for a long time making noise, I don't recommend you leave it, because when it's noisy, that indicates there's a problem with the wheel bearing. And you don't know when it's actually going to fail. I mean, it could be tomorrow, it could be 6 months, but why take a chance? So the most important thing is to have the wheel bearing replaced right away. If you leave your wheel bearing too long and it actually fails, there can be catastrophic problems. Your wheels could come off, which would be probably the worst scenario. But other things can happen too. If it develops too much play in the wheel, it can damage brake parts, it can ruin your hubs, it can cause a lot of extra costly damage. So best thing to do, replace it as soon as you hear noise. That's the cheapest way to repair it and safest. As a conscientious vehicle owner, you might wonder, what can you do to prevent your wheel bearings from failure? And for the most part, there isn't anything you can do. For the unitized wheel bearings or the press-in wheel bearings, they'll just fail when they do. You just replace them when they go bad. They don't need any service. For the tapered roller bearings, though, they do need service every once in a while, probably every 50 to 100,000 kilometers, 30 to 60,000 miles. It's good to repack the wheel bearings, and they can be readjusted if there's play that develops in the wheel bearing.